There are much more geeks who know the Star Wars costume than people who know about really historical hill tribe costumes of Laos. You know, so it's like fiction becoming more popular than reality. And reality becoming lost. Laos has incredible shapes. I mean, when you travel and you, when you start to get interested, you have people living in villages, you have people living in the mud, basically, away from everything, and they have incredible jewelry, really elaborate costume. You travel around and you see all those beautiful things that are disappearing. You have a sense of emergency. You want to record everything. You want to snap a picture of every costume before they fade away. I mean, because it does. It's passing really fast. And that costume that deserve to be still around. So if there's one element of the costume you can save, just one thing you can save from that costume, just only the buttons, and you can turn into different shape, like cufflinks that can survive, or earrings, but you keep that shape. For example, Taidam buttons, they're in shape of insects, and they're very iconic of the Taidam. Each clan and family has different buttons, and they're all handmade. You still find some of those buttons, the antique one, in antique shops. People sell them one by one, they don't even know their buttons anymore. You have the kids of the, running the shop, their parents are not here, they're selling the stuff. They think they are pendants or earrings or whatever. They don't even know they are from that tribe. You need a Taidam person who says, "Hey, those are buttons," you know. And yeah, there's a sense of emergency to gather information before no one can tell. Because all those items are beautiful and unique.
Okay, look at something like that. You think they can come out with something like that in Star Wars?